Hi, my name's Chris Bunce. I'm a professor of translational cancer biology. I'm a scientist, not a clinician. My background is as a cell biologist. And I've become very, very interested in tackling the problem of myeloma. I've become very aware talking to patients, talking to carers, talking to people who work in charity settings that we as blood cancer scientists need to try and do more about prevention. And myeloma is a real case where we can do that because there are early stages of the disease which we can diagnose and detect. Why are we interested in early diagnosis in myeloma? As in all cancers, early diagnosis is better. The earlier the diagnosis is made, the better the health of the patient at the time of that diagnosis, the more resilient they are to therapy, the better they will respond to therapy, and the better journey they're going to have with their disease. But in myeloma, it's particularly important because we know that this disease has very vague early symptoms, and as a consequence, is often diagnosed late. So the majority of patients, in fact, are actually being diagnosed with advanced disease. So we've got our backs against the wall, and individual patients have their backs against the wall right from the start. Everybody who has ultimately a diagnosis of myeloma will have, whether they know it or not, passed through a period when they had a precursor condition. And the precursor condition that we're focusing on is called monoclonal gammopathy of undetermined significance, or MGUS. And we know that we can diagnose this very common condition very easily using the same test that we would use to diagnose or to recognize the presence of myeloma. So we have a golden opportunity to actually catch this disease in the very, very early stages. The problem is that if we do that, we're going to identify a large number of patients or individuals that are even asymptomatic, so it's difficult to call them patients, who will have MGUS and who will never go on to get myeloma. And the challenge for us as biologists is to try and look into that in more detail and identify those MGUS individuals that are at risk of going on to get myeloma. And those individuals are not. And those individuals, we can just say, you have this condition, for you it's not important, go and live your lives normally. And for those that it is important, we can say, well, we've discovered this early, it's really good that we've discovered this early, and now we can do something about it. So the funding that we've just received from Myeloma UK is groundbreaking for us. The innovation that we want to bring about, which is to find the answers to the challenges of instigating a screening program so that we could discover MGUS and delineate those patients that are going to go on to get myeloma or not. This is quite challenging. It's a radically different way to approach it. And we really needed that first set of funding to get this idea out there, to start generating data and start convincing people that this is an approach that could work. And the two PhD studentships that this award will support are going to address that in two different ways. One is going to use what we call big data. So we're going to use patient data, patient characteristics, information about the nature of their MGUS. And then we're going to use what people often call artificial intelligence approaches or machine learning approaches, basically big computers, that will look for patterns in this data that may not be obvious to the human eye, just looking at sheets and sheets and sheets, spreadsheets of data, to identify the characteristics or the pattern of characteristics, if you like, the constellation of characteristics that associate with an MGUS patient that will get myeloma and one that will not. So that's very much a computer-based project, but they will work very closely alongside the other PhD student who will be doing the other important aspect of the study, which is to culture samples of MGUS cells from patients in the laboratory to learn about their biology. Now, this has been very difficult up until now, but we have recently managed to develop a system where we think we can culture MGUS cells and study them in a way that they've never been studied before. So we're going to be using that system to look within the MGUS cells and to find out, do they have a unique drug target? Do they have something different about them that we can generate a low toxicity therapy that will target that difference and not be toxic for the body as a whole. The way it's going to help is that it's, we're going to find the information that will unlock the possibility to begin a targeted screening program. The very real drive behind this is not just to have some scientific understanding that's exciting in the laboratory. This is about changing policy, changing approach, and changing the way the NHS can tackle this difficult problem. What I think the research will achieve in the future is a change of attitude. And a change of attitude is what is required. At the moment, we have an attitude within the myeloma research space is that myeloma is a very difficult problem, and that what we need is more and more drugs to treat the end stages of the disease to get longer and more common remissions and improve the quality of life at that end of the disease. What we're doing is trying to promote a radically different way of thinking about it. And our way of thinking about it is, what if myeloma wasn't an issue anymore because we had an intervention program so that we could discover people that were at risk of getting myeloma and eliminate that risk or control that risk so that myeloma doesn't occur?